The IIT Bombay Mars Rover Project is a student technical initiative to build working prototypes of rovers having all-terrain traversing capability. The primary aim of the team this year was to build a more robust design by learning from our experiences in URC 2018 and explore more creative tech-savvy solutions to the identified challenges in the project.
Having identified certain inefficiencies or differential steer and challenges with precise arm control in our last year's design, this year's iteration aims to improve upon these by having an independent steer and a robotic arm primarily motioned via actuators. The four-wheeled rocker bogie suspension system provides superior traversal over the extremely uneven surfaces. Its primary advantage is its obstacle climbing capability, which has proven to be effective in traversing over big rocks in the field trials. Four-wheel independent steer facilitates steering of the rover according to either Ackerman, independent or differential steer. This gives us the liberty to choose either of the steering schemes as per the terrain and also helps the software team in developing improved algorithms for obstacle avoidance. A custom-built aluminum wheel hub mitigates motor damage from uneven terrain and allows for wheels of various profiles to be tested independently. We are in the process of prototyping different wheel profiles for improved traction.
With the motive of improving control precision and operability, the 6DUF robotic arm design consists of linear actuators as far as possible.
The arm-elbow link is designed in a bent shape to increase the strength of the link and also accommodate all the actuators. The robotic arm has an open truss design to minimize weight without compromising on strength. We have opted for a three-finger gripper for better grasping, rotation, and manipulation of various objects. To ease the base station, operability, and accurate positioning, a laser and depth camera has also been mounted. Our soil collection assembly consists of a 4-bar mechanism along with a 2-jaw 3D printed soil collector to collect the dry soil sample in water-filled container. Biosensors have been directly embedded in the soil collector for preliminary soil analysis. We have also used an ATP counter to detect viable cells. The soil solution is taken onto a cotton swab and mixed with provided chemicals and then placed inside the ATP counter.
This year's electronic and software subsystem has focused on two critical aspects, the base station operability and working in tandem with the mechanical subsystem.
We have an Intel NUC as a main onboard computer along with ARPA-S and Arduino. The circuit has been schemed out neatly in a completely detachable box with a kill switch and battery voltage monitoring LED. The Ruckus P300 COM module boasts 1 km of NLOS operation and has been tested multiple times to affirm the same. To mitigate against adverse COM blackouts, we predict sharply decreasing trends in signal strength via time series prediction algorithms. We visualize the feedback of encoders of arm motors and actuators and a mounted depth camera via Rover's URDF in RVs. This allows for a complete description of both the arm and the 3D environment in its vicinity, thus leveraging an extra dimension as compared to conventional video feedback at the base station. We have also developed a Django-based web GUI for controlling various components of the robotic arm, along with virtual joysticks to control the rover drive and steer. For the autonomous task, a turntable assembly allows for a 360-degree scan for ball detection and also isolates the smartphone IMU from electronic interferences from motors. For level 3 autonomy, we utilize the GPS and IMU feedback from a self-developed Android app. For ease of testing and visualization, we have developed another app which provides target GPS coordinates and also visualizes the rover's current pose. We leverage an iterative algorithm which corrects for heading offsets when going from a GPS point to another. We get laser scan data from a YD lidar and detect the obstacles in rover trajectory via clustering of the scan data using the obstacle detector package. The turntable assembly takes multiple pictures by rotating approximately 20 degrees between each click. A deep learning classification algorithm gives the most probable picture to which the rover aligns. The rover then moves forward until a distance of less than 2 meters from the ball is inferred from the increasing pixel size of the detected ball.
The rover subsystem have been designed, implemented and executed with an eye for improved performance in competition conditions. This has been corroborated by the competent performance of our rover in numerous field trials. Over the few next months, we plan on further improving and evaluating both the rover design as well as execution of tasks from the valuable inputs we have gained from our field trials. We are hence confident of a good show in URC 2019.